In this video, I will introduce some logic objects for message passing. The simplest object is the relay. The relay simply forwards all messages from inputs to outputs. You can use it to reduce clutter. The OR gate combines multiple inputs into one by sending a single ON message when either of the inputs are on, and a single OFF message when all inputs are off. So with this arrangement, the door will open when I attack either or both of the levers. It will not close again until they are both off. This is different from connecting them both to the door directly, because then the door rejects the message from the second switch when it is already open. The AND gate is like the OR gate, except that it requires multiple inputs to be on. This number can be specified here. So with this arrangement, the door will only open when both levers are pulled. The NOT gate can be used to invert messages, so that OFF messages become ON, and vice versa. So with this arrangement, the door will be open as long as not both of the levers are pulled. The BOOL expression trigger can be used to express logic more concisely. This object evaluates an expression and sends an ON message when the expression is true, or an OFF message when it is false. The expression is a form of Boolean algebra, so to use this object it is recommended that you are somewhat familiar with that. In this example I have a lever which sets the key dingus, and another lever which increments the counter hits. If I want the door to open when this lever has been pulled, and this lever has been pulled 3 times, then I can write this. You can press this button to check for errors. If there is an error, the error window will pop up. The Boolean expression can consist of values, operators, and parentheses. You can use the literals true and false, although they are not particularly useful. To check if a key has been added, simply type the key name. If the key is in a non-default key set, then you can type the key set name followed by a period and the key name. To check if a section is visible, you can type a dollar symbol and the name of an object in that section. You can compare a counter to an integer using this type of expression. It consists of square brackets, the counter name, a comparison operator, and an integer. There should be no spaces inside of the square brackets. This is a list of the comparison operators that can be used. You can use these Boolean operators between values. The Boolean expression language uses the same operator precedence and associativity as conventional programming languages such as C. Also, you can group sub-expressions by using balanced parentheses, as in this example. I will put this in the video description. To create even more complex logic, you can use Python scripts. I will introduce that in the next video.